गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। सो वेरी हैप्पी इंडिपेंडेंस डे टू ऑल ऑफ यू। लेट्स हैंड्स चेंजेस टू देंस, HENCE, फाइन। सो बेटा, दिस इज द चेंज इन द टाइम टेबल, सो अकॉर्डिंगली यू हैव टू ज्वाइन। परमानेंट चेंज, नॉट अ टेम्पररी वन। Now we are doing direct indirect speech. Almost we have done all the rules, but one segment was left, fine. Imperative sentences were left and WH questions were left. Yes, no, vale, we have done, fine. So let's continue. Firstly, note down this change in words, fine. Now changes to then, today, that day. Tonight, that night, tomorrow, the next day, because this day is not yet arrived, so that's why we use the word the next day. Yes, Tanya, get up from there. Shift on the third desk. Yes. Then, yesterday, the previous day, the day which has been passed. Then we have last night, the previous night. Some boys are talking. Then we have thus changes to so. Thus changes to so. So kindly note down this change of words. Clear? This was the last table. Two tables we have already made. Change of tenses and change of pronouns. So this is the last table of changes. And now we'll be doing imperative sentences. Yes, beta? Yes, thence. Hence changes to thence. So you can see I'm using tricolor to give you the feel of Independence Day. Yes. Yes, the following day is also correct. The next day or the following day is correct. I don't want to create confusion. That's why I have. So in yesterday also, the day before, in that way we do. Yes. Everybody better note it down. Send me the feedback, children sitting at home, so that I can move forward. 4-5 students have written, rest are left. So I'm giving you a minute to note down. Now we'll be starting. Statements we have done, reported statements. Interrogative, yes. But WH interrogative we have not done. Fine. So now we'll be doing interrogative second part. We have done interrogative sentences that day also, but only yes or no questions. Daksh, you change your seat. Get up. The previous day, last night, the previous night, thus changes to so. Last night, that's why I'm saying change your seat. Rather than asking again and again, there is enough of space today. So you changed it, now you see, that's it. Keep your mouth shut. Fine, so let's continue with interrogative questions now. Interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentences. So when interrogative sentences, part one we have done. What was part one? When you have questions whose answer can be given in yes or no, we use if for whether. So that we have already done. Clear? Now we'll be doing second part. WH questions. What, where, when, whom, and how also. Plus one H, how. Clear? So whenever we'll be having the direct statement in interrogative form, where a WH question is asked, those who are disturbing the class will be the ones to give answer. Fine. So I'm just going to repeat. If we have direct statements which are interrogative and they are the WH questions or starting from how, etc. It means if I ask you what's your name, there will be an answer to it. Fine. If I ask you, do you want to attend online class? Answer will be in yes or no. Fine. In that case, we used if and whether. But in the case when there is proper answer, then we are going to do those sentences. Let's do the example. He said to me, one example you'll do, it will be clear to you. He said to me, comma, inverted comma, start, whom does she want to contact? Whom does she want to contact? Clear? So, said to will be changed in asked, inquired in that way because it is a question. Fine. So reported speech firstly changes. Said to will change to asked. Clear? He asked me. Now, beta, in this what you will do? You will not add any conjunction. That nahi lagaoge aap. He asked me whom she wanted to contact. Whom she, firstly you will make the change here. This will change to asked or inquired depending upon the sentence. He asked me. Now no conjunction will be added. That nahi lagana apne. He asked me. It remains the same only. And tense changes. Whom she. See. Present indefinite changes to past indefinite. Clear? Beta, you have to see the tense. Fine. Secondly, you will not make it a question whom she wanted to contact. See the tense. Full stop. Now the things to remember is, firstly, said to will change to asked or inquired. Secondly, you will remove, you will not use any conjunction in it. Thirdly, remove inverted commas. WH words remain the same. It does not change. Whom ka how nahi kar doge. Clear? Or what nahi kar doge. Fine. Both of you can leave the class. Daksha and Parikshit. Least interested in the class. So sit at home better. Your parents will be informed. So, fine. You have to see the tense. Which tense is used here? Simple present. Present indefinite use hue, present indefinite changes to past indefinite. What is the rule of past indefinite? V2. Simple hai. Clear? So that's why want changes to wanted here. Do does remove ho jayega. Clear? And you were asking, beta, did kyun nahi laga? Yes, this boy now is not responding even. Do does changes to did? Fine. Aapko tense dekhna in that way. Got it? Now, one more example of same thing. One more sentence, kindly note down. They said to us, they said to us, comma, inverted comma, start. How have you solved this sum? How have HAVE? They said to us, comma, inverted comma, start. How have you solved this sum? Yes, you give me the answer. Parikshit, change it into indirect. Yes, Dakshu, just keep sitting. That अभी मैंने बताया दैट नहीं लगना है इंटरोगेटिव में. दिस सम दैट सम तभी मैंने एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ वर्ड्स लिखवाया था. क्लियर? बैठो. गुड दैट यू ट्राइड एट लीस्ट एंड हाफ आंसर. अगर लेकिन बेटा इन एग्जाम इफ हाफ द आंसर इज करेक्ट नो मार्क्स विल बी गिवन टू यू. क्लियर? एक भी चीज रह जाएगी दैट इट्स अ जीरो. सो यू हैव टू कन्वर्ट अकॉर्डिंगली. क्लियर? They asked us how we had solved that sum. They asked us how we had solved that sum. Yes, beta. You remains you. Beta, they said to us. Statement dekho. They said to us, how have you solved this sum? They asked us how we had solved that sum. I'm getting your point. You are getting confused. You remains you in that way. But here, beta, the thing is, how have you solved the sum? That they asked us only. That how we have solved this. This is correct. Clear? Agar you remains the you, that will be a direct speech only. It changes. It depends upon the sentence only. Basic idea is clear. How to do WH questions? Any doubt? Children sitting at home, send me your feedback, beta. Fine. So most of you are saying yes. Those who are sitting there, others who just joined in for the sake of joining. So let's continue. We'll be doing imperative sentences now. Yes, Dak, stand up. दक्ष पढ़े हुई जल्दी से. टेल मी व्हाट आर द इंपेरेटिव सेंटेंसेस. यस इंपेरेटिव सिंपल वेरी गुड. व्हाट एन आंसर. दैट्स व्हाई यू पीपल सिट टॉकिंग ऑल द टाइम. So we are going to do imperative sentences now. Anybody else who want to answer? Baith jao. Imperative sentences, beta, in which any advice is given, any request is made, any command is given. Fine. So all those sentences which seem to be giving command, order, advice or request to others, they all are considered as imperative sentences. Clear? So write down. In that way you can write. This is a hint to you. Request, command, advice, etc. So that you remember what are imperative sentences. Clear? Command or order, one and same thing. Fine. Now I'll be telling you which words can be used in place of request. In place of request, you can use request also directly. Beg also if it's a he begged in front of him, saying that in that way, clear. And also appeal. These are the synonyms, fine, which you can use in the reporting verb. Clear? Request, in place of request, it can be beg or appeal. In case of advice, it can be, in case of command, beta, order, or command itself, same word can be used, but synonym also. And then, in case of advice, it can be an urge. Urge or advice, both words can be used. Clear? So, these are the imperative sentences. Very easy it is. First rule is, no conjunction is used. Write down the rules for imperative sentences. Rules. First rule is, yes, beta. Urge. U-R-G-E. Urge means to request someone. I urge you not to talk in the class. This is my urge to you all. Fine? Example. Demand can be in command. Fine? Demanded, it is a command only, and it's not an advice, it's not a request. A-P-P-E-A-L-E-D hoega. Obviously, when we change it into that, he appealed. Yes. So, now, write down, beta, first rule says, no conjunction is used to introduce the reported speech. The way we have done in interrogative. No conjunction is used to introduce the reported speech, means that aapne remove kar dena in simple language. Fine? In layman's language, I'm making you understand that no conjunction means aapne that nahi laga. Clear? Then, the imperative word, second rule is, bas do rules yaad rakhne mainly. Write down, I'm making you write only. The imperative word means whatsoever request, appeal, command is made. Fine. The imperative word is changed into infinitive. These words seem to be difficult, but actually they are not. Very easy it is. I'll make you understand. आपने ऐसे नहीं लिखना, I'm writing in short form. You write complete sentence. Rule number 2 says, the imperative word is changed into infinitive one. Infinitive one by putting two before the verb. By putting T-O-2. Inverted commas में two को लिखना. By putting two before the verb. Let's do one example. Okay, before I start telling you, I'll be speaking one sentence and you people will raise hand and you will tell me whether it's a request or order or advice. Very simple it is. Those who are attentive enough in the class, for them. Have a cup of tea with me, please. Raise your hand. It's a request. I'm saying just raise your hand and then speak. It's not the vegetable market, fine. Yes, right, Princy, you have given correct answer. It's a request. Next is, help me. Help me. Yes. See, why you were hesitant of raising hand now? Again, it's a request only. Because I didn't use please here. Help me, please. Bolo to clear ho jayega. Next is, prepare a cup of tea for me. It's a command. Prepare a cup of tea for me, please. Fine, so it depends. See, one word can change the meaning of whole sentence. That's why I say use your language wisely. Clear? So it is very much clear that you can bifurcate, which is a request and command and all. So let's do one example. Write down first example of imperative sentence. The teacher said to the boys, the teacher said to the boys, comma, inverted comma, start, take out your books. Take out your books. T should be capital. Take out your books and read them silently. Take out your books and read them silently. So, is it a request or command? Yes, the teacher is ordering the boys. So, the teacher ordered the boys. Yes, to take out their books, beta. Ab ye dekho, unko bola na, take out your books. Yes, it remains same only. You will be adding an infinitive to. The teacher ordered the boys. Ab aapne conjunction nahi lagana hai, uski jagah pe infinitive to add kar dena. The teacher ordered the boys to take out their books and read them silently, full stop. Commanded is also correct. Yes. Next is, my servant said to me, comma, inverted comma, start, sir, let me go out for an hour. Sir, let me go out for an hour to meet my friend who is ill. Obviously, it is a request, fine? So change the whole sentence and then raise your hand. Don't speak while sitting. I repeat the question. My servant said to me, comma, inverted comma, start, sir, comma, let me go out for an hour, H-O-U-R, to meet my friend who is ill, full stop, comma, closes. Don't speak like that. Those who know the answer, raise your hands. Firstly, write down. Bisham has given the answer already on the screen. Fine, Bisham, it is correct. Yes, Parina. My servant begged me. It's not a begging, it is not a... Begging will be used in a case when there is a utter request, sheer request made that there is no choice, fine? Requested word you will be using. Yes. Yes, who was ill? Very good. My servant, yes, appealed is fine. My servant requested me to let him go out. To let him go out for an hour to meet his friend who was ill. Two ke saath first form aata hai. Clear? Infinitive is always used with V1. So do not have any confusion. Fine? Last imperative sentence. Mohan said to me, comma, inverted comma, start. Would you like to have a cup of tea with me? Very good advice. The advice hai. This is an invitation. So use your brain. Sometimes it is not the same word. Yes. Sit down now. No, sit down, sit down. No. This is not the right way. Without listening to the question. Bad job. No, beta. Aapki turn nahi hai. Baitho aap. This question will be given to someone else now. I don't want to listen. I'm not listening even. Saksham Grover, you will give the answer to this. Mohan said to me, would you like to have a cup of tea with me? Mohan invited me to have a cup of tea with him. This is the answer. Mohan invited me, or you can also beta add up warmly invited me. Mohan invited me to have a cup of tea with him. Full stop. Yes, beta. You have to see beta. Yes or no is other case. It is like an invitation, so it becomes imperative sentence. So you have to find out yes or no wala jo hoga wo imperative nahi hona chahiye phir. There is a condition to this. Fine. I ask you some other question which is not any advice or not a request. Fine. In that way, will you go to a station with me? ठीक है, इन दैट वे वो यस और नो में आ गया. इन दैट वे तो यहाँ पे इनविटेशन है, वो एक कैजुअल आस्किंग है टू आस्क कि जाना है मेरे साथ के नहीं. इट्स लाइक ही इज इनवाइटिंग हिम ऑन द टी. देयर इज अ डिफरेंस ऑफ इंपेरेटिव एंड यस और नो. फाइन, डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज. गुड, यू आस्क दिस क्वेश्चन. सो लास्ट वन मोर बेटा, एडवाइस बेस्ड करते हैं. प्रशांत सेड टू मी, प्रशांत लास्ट ऑफ दिस एडवाइस बेस्ड है ये. Prashant said to me, comma, inverted comma, start. You should not eat so much. Prashant said to me, comma, inverted comma, start. You should not eat so much. Full stop, comma, closes. Nobody will give answer. Yes, beta. Prashant said to me, you should not eat so much. Should remain should. I told you beta that you will be adding two. ठीक है, conjunction हटा देनी है, two add कर देना infinitive. So क्या आएगा बताओ. प्रशांत advised me. सुन लो पहले, you should not eat so much. इसको कैसे change करेंगे? Very easy it is, the easiest. Yes, Raina. Do not eat so much. स्लो क्लास फॉर दिस. इतनी देर से मैं एक चीज समझा रही हूँ, आपको समझ ही नहीं आ रही है. यस दिव्यांश, दैट भी लग रहा है, सब कुछ हो रहा है. बैठ जाओ. प्रशांत एडवाइज्ड मी नॉट टू ईट सो मच. प्रशांत Advised me. Advised beta, C and S दो advice होते हैं. Can anybody tell me the difference? एक होता है advice, ये वाला. Is it visible? No. एक होता है ये वाला advice. एक होता है A D V I S. What is the difference? Anybody knows? This is the noun. I give you one advice. ये noun बन जाता है कि मैं आपको एक advice देती हूँ. I give you one advice. I advise you not to talk. I advise you not to eat too much. So ये verb है. S वाला verb. Fine. This is the difference. Is it clear to all of you? So we have completed all the topics of our syllabus. Revision starts from Monday.